Okay, do we have Lydia on the line? Is Lydia on the line? Line 7? Okay, beautiful.
Oh, cool.
All right.
This is a red letter moment, Dennis.
You know, for years, on Saturday afternoons around 5 o'clock on my local PBS channel, I saw this woman, this Italian woman, making Italian dishes.
And all you ever got for Christmas?
Yeah.
For the last, like, 10 years?
Was Lydia Bastianich's book.
Exactly.
Lydia, welcome to the show. Benvenuti.
Benvenuti. Buongiorno, Dennis. Buongiorno, Judy.
Great to talk to you.
Oh, my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Sure.
You have been such a great influence on so many people who love Italian cooking, who are from Italian-American families, and some who are just love the kind of food you cook. And your presentation, the way you presented it, makes it so easy to follow and replicate.
Yeah, it is. It's kind of family cooking, straightforward. And that's what Italian is. It's simple, great products, the best products you can get, and elaborate them as little as possible. So people really do follow my recipes and, I guess, watch my shows, and I'm glad you do.
Well, let me tell you something. First of all, and I'm a huge fan of Italian food as well. Dennis tries to be you, but doesn't always succeed. But there's one thing that Dennis loves, and he loves to make it, but it's very, very labor intensive.
Mm.
What's that?
The rice balls.
Arancini.
Oh. Arancini. Yeah, they are. They are. But you know what? You can make a lot of them, and they go a long way once you have the system going.
Yeah, you got to have a system. I usually do it alone, because nobody wants to be next to me in a fryer all day. But if you have two people, it goes fast. Like making ravioli, it's better with two people.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, rolling them first. But you have a kind of systematic, you know, make the rice, then season it, then roll it, then fry it.
Yeah, definitely. If you do it the other way, you got a problem. My people come from Calabria.
Ah, nice and spicy food, Calabrese.
Absolutely. Now, Lydia's people come from a part of that's no longer part of Italy, or is it still?
You know, Italy has 20 regions, so all the way up in the northeast, the right-hand corner under Austria, near Slovenia, is Friuli, Venezia, Giulia. That's one region.
Right.
And I come from that region, but there's a little peninsula called Istria, which after World War II was given to the communist Yugoslavia that was formed after the war. So Italy lost that piece of land, and that's where I was born, and my family had to kind of escape back into Italy, and then we moved on into America.
Have you been back there?
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
To that little region?
I have. Now it's Croatia.
Right.
Uh-huh. So it's democratic, and it's more accessible. And I do go because I still have grandma's house there, you know, where I used to go and visit grandma and play with grandma. So I go there with much anticipation.
Oh,
I've seen that
gorgeous
video. I've seen a video of her going back and
that's beautiful,
cooking with mama and going to the old house. But Lydia, you are an extraordinary example of the American dream, and for a woman to achieve the kind of business success you
be it in Italy or be it in Yugoslavia, had we remained there. So you know, it takes hard work. It takes, you know, I'm passionate about this. I love what I do. And I think that all helps. But also the message is very accepted by Americans. Americans love Italy and they love Italian food. And here I am. I have two of the greatest cultures on my back, shall we say. Born Italian and raised American, and you put them together, and it's a success story.
That's beautiful.
So happy for you. And if people want to come and see you at the Count Basie Theater, what's the date and time?
November 4th at 6:30. I will be in Red Bank at the Count Basie Theater, and it will be an intimate conversation with Lydia Bastianich, and we will be talking about my new book, Lydia Mastering the Art of Italian Cuisine. And it's a comprehensive book. It has more than 400 recipes.
Wow.
And, you know, it's one of those books that kind of, it took me, you know, I have 10 books. This is the 10th book. But this is kind of the collection of all the wisdom, of all the mentoring. And I'm sharing it with the readers, with the viewers, with the chefs. chefs out there.
Well, now I know what I'm getting for Dennis for Christmas, Lydia. Thank you.
Lydia, one of my favorite recipes that I've used from your book is you took escarole
yes.
with meat and cheese and put it in a little puff pastry and baked it.
Oh, and that's delicious. That is so good. That's from Napoli, though.
That's a Naples? That's a Napolitan dish?
Yeah, that's Napolitano. That's Campania. So, but it's a delicious. You know, Italians love their vegetables. And dough and vegetables, and you put them together, and how can you miss?
You're amazing, and I wish you all success in the world with the new book.
And we love the Count Basie. That's going to be a beautiful event.
You're going to enjoy your evening there.
I'm really looking forward to.
So once again, it's November 4th.
At 6:30 p.m., you know, we'll be chatting away, and then at the end, opening up for questions and personalizing the books and taking photos, so whatever anybody would like, I will be there.
That's great.
You come across in a phone conversation, much as you do on your TV show, very warm and down to earth, and we wish you all the best, Lydia.
Thanks very much. Thanks, Dennis. Thanks, Judy.
Thank you for being here with us. We appreciate it.
Okay.
Okay, bye-bye.
I love her.
She's so adorable.